In the position indicated by the red arrows, on the left and right side of the cartridge, there are two small pins. With a pair of flush-cutting wire cutters, pull the pins out. Separate the two halves of the cartridge, toner section and drum section. On the drum section, remove the two screws. Remove the drum bushing. Remove the drum. The drum, probably, is not reusable. Remove the charge roller. It's not necessary to remove the wiper blade, but if you want to replace it, remove the two screws. The wiper blade, remove the waste toner from the drum. Do not damage or distort the thin mylar recovery blade next to the wiper blade. The recovery blade guides the toner that the wiper blade removed from the drum into the waste chamber. If this blade is bent or damaged in any way, it should be replaced. On the toner section, remove the drum cover by prying the spring-loaded arm. Be careful not to lose the spring. Pry off the two metal bars out of their holders. Remove the drum cover. Remove the two screws from the gear side end cap. Remove the end cap. Note the same of the gears, stay with it. Do not remove this large gear. The gears are two in the high capacity cartridges. They drive the mixing augers inside the cartridge and are very hard to replace properly if removed. Remove the magnetic roller from the cartridge. The toner is held to the magnetic roller by the stationary magnet inside the sleeve. Be careful with the magnetic roller bushings. They are very fragile. The bushings keep a specific gap from the magnetic roller to the drum. The edges of the drum ride directly on these bushings. Remove the two screws of the doctor blade. They are longer than all the other screws used in this cartridge. Keep these screws separate. Remove the two white plastic spacers. Remove the doctor blade. Clean out any remaining toner from the cartridge. Do not try to reuse toner left inside of the supply hopper. It's mostly waste toner. If used, will cause printing problems. It's better to use compressed air. If not, clean the cartridge as well as possible at open air. Do not breathe a ton of dust. The doctor blade must be perfectly straight. Clean the doctor blade with isopropyl alcohol. The doctor blade controls the amount of toner on the magnetic roller. Gently clean the developer roller with isopropyl alcohol. The developer roller carries the toner from the supply chamber to the drum. Clean the charge roller with water. The charge roller places the initial charge on the drum, as well as erases the residual charge at the end of the cycle. There is no fill hole in these cartridges, so it must be filled through the doctor blade slot. Fill the cartridge with 300 grams of toner for the standard cartridge, and 600 grams for the high capacity cartridge. Clean the magnetic roller seals. Make attention not to damage the magnetic roller sealing blade. Reinstall the doctor blade and the two screws. Install the magnetic roller with its bushings. Note that the two bushings are different. Install the gear end cap and two screws. Turn the stationary magnet so that the key end will fit into the end cap. If the end cap does not fit, the stationary magnet inside the roller most likely is not set correctly. On the drum section, install the charge roller. Original drums are not reusable, but compatible drums last longer. If you want to reuse the drum, clean it with isopropyl alcohol. In case you use a new drum, probably you need to reuse the old drum hub. Lubricate the drum with toner, or the wiper blade may damage it. Slide the drum onto the pin until it is seated. Install the drum bushing and two screws. Place the two halves together. Reinstall the two pins. They should protrude from the flat wall of the cartridge, so you can easily remove them again. Make sure the springs are in the right position. Install the spring in the drum cover arm, as shown in the video. Install the metal bar into the hole and slot. Install the arm. Release the tail of the spring so that the cover closes. A used chip, do not shut down the printer. But the tunnel function is disabled. The cartridge will run if the chip is removed. But first you have to clear an error message. Remove the old chip and install the new chip. To hold the chip in its slot, use a bit of glue. And the work is done. For any problem with the cartridge, here you'll find a troubleshooting guide.